Hi, I'm your hostess for the new show, Strictly for Seniors. And I want to tell you that it's a new concept for BCTV, and it's my next career since I retired from the county. I'm going to have I'll just give you a real quick format of how we're going to do the show each week. It's going to be on Sunday nights at 7 o'clock. And the first week in each month, I'm going to do hobbies. The second week, I'm going to do educational stuff. The third week, I'm going to do... The second week, we're going to do things that you need to know about retirement. The third week, we're going to do all the different colleges. And the fourth week, we're going to do the senior centers. So, no matter what you're interested in, it's going to go out on YouTube the next day if you don't get BCTV, and you can review the old shows on YouTube. Today, I have with me John Vogel, who is like Mr. Medicare Expert. This man is like... His brain is like a sponge. It just grabs all this stuff. And so I called him immediately because when I had to go on Medicare, as soon as I retired from the county in December, I started navigating this maze. And I thought, if I'm going through this, you guys are going to be going through it too. And so those of you that are getting ready to sign up for Medicare, we're going to tell you about that. After you're on it, we're going to tell you about that, and we're going to tell you what kind of options you have. So, John, honest to goodness, he's just a fountain of knowledge. It cracks me up. He goes around and does. You do presentations.
Yes, I do all the time. Thank you, Sandy. Thanks for inviting me in.
Oh my gosh, I just love having you here. This is so fun. First of all, let's start with, if you're getting ready to retire, what do you need to do?
Okay, well, you know what? I normally don't do this, but I'm going to take about a minute and a half to explain how Medicare was ever established. Where did it come from? So, believe it or not,
Our federal government
actually signed into law, wait till you hear the year, 1965.
Yeah.
Wow. 1965, they signed into law Medicare. Now, a lot of people think Medicare has always been here, but they signed it into law. The HMO plans were in the 70s. Medicare Choice and Medicare Advantage plans came in 1977. The 2003 Medicare Improvement Act changed everything. And in 2006, they decided to create the Medicare Part D, which is our prescription plan, which changed things for everybody all the way around. In 2010, the Affordable Care Act came in, which changed Medicare again completely. And then we come up to 2022 and the Inflation Protection Act, which is supposed to correct and help us with all of our costs for Medicare. So let's start with the easy things. And I thought I'd bring along.
Let me just say one thing. And it cracks me up because Medicare is paid for by your donations over the years. When you're working and you are paying into Social Security.
Part of that is
Medicare. So it's your dollars that are coming back to you. And this big hoopla. Every time there's an election and they'll say, oh, if you elect this person, they're going to cut your Social Security benefits. Social Security is going bankrupt. Medicare is going bankrupt.
None of it is. None of it is. So let me show you, just so you know, especially for now, anybody that's been in Medicare, you know what this red, white, and blue card looks like. And of course, it says sample across there. This is your red, white, and blue card. Now, yours is not as big as mine.
As you get older,
you have to have it a little bit larger. And this card here, if anyone that was around in the early part of Medicare and up until about 5 years ago, you had your Social Security number on your Medicare card. And they removed that about 5 years ago, and they put on the card, the new card, looking like this, has a Medicare personal ID number on it. And that ID number belongs specifically to you.
And which, you're supposed to guard that number, aren't you?
Yeah, absolutely, positively. Just because it's a new Medicare ID number does not mean, and one day you and I are going to talk all about Medicare fraud.
Yeah, because we'll do another show on that.
It happens as crazy as ever. On your Medicare card, you're going to see that it only says Part A or Part B on it? Very simple, easy explanation of Part A is when you're actually physically admitted into the hospital. Not an emergency room, not transitional care, not when you think you're in the hospital. It is Part A pays when you are actually physically admitted into the hospital. Part B of our Medicare, which is the other part that appears on our card.
Is that right? Is that what that is? That's the hospital part, huh?
Yes, Part A.
I'll be part A.
So Part B is actually what you and I use. If we go to the doctor, if we go to a specialist, if we go get blood work done, if we go get an x-ray done, if we are in the emergency room, our Part B. Now, the difference between the two, Sandy, is really easy. Part A, for about 99% of the country, is free. Doesn't cost anything. And that's where that money that you were just saying that they took out and every pays for our Part A. Now, Part B has a monthly premium. And from our Social Security check every month, if you're collecting your Social Security, they deduct $174 a month out of your Social Security to pay for Part B of Medicare. So A is free. B has a monthly premium. So that's basically let me on your card.
I just want to tell you one thing which I found very interesting. When you hit 65, well, we were 65, 1965 because of our ages.
Mm-hmm.
Some of the other folks, as the age goes up, they can't get 100% Social Security until they're 66, 67, whatever. When you hit that age, you immediately get Part A hooked onto your name somehow or another, because I had to go sign up for Part A right away when I went on Social Security.
Well, the interesting part about it is if you don't sign up for Part A when you are first eligible, here comes something that the federal government did to all of us, penalties. And the penalties can be expensive, so it does make perfect sense. Now, the one little glitch in this, if you are having a monthly donation, I hate to use that word, but if you are monthly putting in something into a health savings account, if you are doing that, you have to stop putting the money into a health savings account because you can't sign up for Part A or Part B if you're going to continue to contribute. So I have a lot of people who continue to work.
I did.
Exactly.
I worked another 20 years.
You know, so they go past the age 65. I have many, many more people working to be at least 66 and 6 months old, but a lot of people working to be 70. Because at age 70, even though people say it all the time, no, at age 70 is when you can collect your full Social Security benefit.
Is that what the age is up to now?
70. That's 66 years and 6 months. You collect your full earned Social Security amount. There is a difference between the word full and full earned, because at 66 and 6 months, if you continue to work, then at age 70, you can't contribute any more in, so you can get your full Social Security. So you do have that option at age 65 if you're gonna continue to work. I recommend to everybody stop putting the money into your HSA and go into Medicare Part A only if you're going to continue to get coverage from your company, simply and solely because you don't want to get caught with penalties. You hate penalties.
Let me just tell you a little story, okay? I had my own company. When I decided to run for office, I was 67. Now, 65 was when I started getting Social Security. Okay. Fine. 67, my county took over my insurance. So now I'm 20 years later. I go down to Social Security and I said, okay, I'm going to retire. I'm going to sign up for Medicare. And they're like, well, this paper only says from 67 on, you were covered by the county. I said, right. They said, well, who covered you the other 2 years from 65 on? I said, my company. They said, well, we need documentation that your company had insurance. I said, you've got to be kidding me. That was 20 years ago. What the heck did I have left over from? They said, well, who was the carrier? I have a good memory, but it's short. Come on, cut me a break, 20 years ago. I am calling doctor's offices. Do you have who my provider was? No, that Rex didn't go back that far. I'm like, I'm going to have to pay a penalty for 2 years because I can't prove that our company had insurance. So I said to my daughter, okay, do we have stationery left over from the company? She said, yeah. I said, okay, give me a piece. So I write, to Social Security from Graffius Burial Vaults. We had health insurance for our employees from 2001 to 2002. And then in 2003, I went to the county. Signed, President Kelly signs it. I take it into Social Security and I said, here's my documentation that I had insurance for my company. The girl said, thank you very much. And she made a copy of it. She said, you will get your card in the mail in 2 weeks. I'm like, the frustration I went through worrying about that penalty, I have no idea what that would have been for 2 years. I just don't know.
Well, yeah. And
but it annoyed me because I wasn't using Medicare, so why are they going to penalize me for not using Medicare?
And that is that happens to many people, Sandy, that they don't realize, and that's where that word becomes so key, penalties. Make sure you really talk to somebody that knows what they're doing to get out of the penalties. Now, the interesting point that you just made there was you were looking for Medicare, but you went to Social Security. I can't tell you how many people said, wait a minute, what do I have to go to Social Security for? Well, Medicare starts at Social Security.
Correct.
And Social Security, believe it or not, now in 2024, will tell you immediately to create your own Medicare account, meaning that you have to go on a computer, you have to create a password, you have to create a document so that you can follow your account. So if you go into Social Security, which I will tell you now, you better make an appointment because there's no more walk-ins. Don't walk into the Social Security office and think you're going to get service.
How do you make an appointment?
You need to call the Social Security, and believe it or not, it is an 800 number here in Berks County. It's not a 610 number. It's an 800 number, which is very confusing within itself.
Where do you think you get that number?
Well, you get it from me easy, but you can get that number from the Area Agency on Aging. You can get it from Berks Encore, or you can call me, you know, really simple from that. From that standpoint, once you signed up for that, you were correct. You're going to get your red, white, and blue card that I just showed you. And depending upon what you sign up for, if you're signing up for both Part A and Part B, you'll get that card with it. Like in your case, if you only signed up for Part A because you were going to be covered,
yeah,
you will only have Part A on it. At some point in time, then, especially with the number of people that are continuing to work, they'll want to sign up for Part B at a later date. Well,
that's
becomes really confusing
that's
because that's where Sandy was sharing about having to prove that she had, now this is the word, this is what they'll tell you, creditable coverage. Coverage equal to or better than Medicare's. And you have to prove it in some way, documentation to have that.
So what you need to do before you go into Social Security is sign up for that second part of Medicare Part B. You have to get proof from your company that you were covered from the time that you started getting Social Security right on through because you hadn't signed up right off the bat for Part A and B. You just get A automatically.
Yep.
But yeah, what happens is, and I know this from experience, your company insurance is your first, that's the first one. And then what your company insurance doesn't pay, then it would fall back to Medicare. But my company insurance was so strong that it just paid everything, and I didn't get back to Medicare.
And then, all of a sudden, it flip-flops.
And I'm like,
it flip-flops.
It changes over. I just go into the doctor, and I go, here are my cards. Figure out what I owe everybody.
Yep. So somewhere along the line, as we go through this, you know, once you have Medicare will be, Part A, in the hospital. The easy thing to remember, you always make this easy, John. Anything out of the hospital is Part B.
Correct.
In A, out B. From that standpoint, Medicare basically says they pay approximately 80% of whatever the medical services are. I have seen over all these 28 years of doing this, Medicare pays more than 80%. Medicare pays less than 80%. Somewhere along the line, that dollar amount that's not being paid has to get paid by somehow. If you have no other coverage, then it's on you. You have to. If you have supplemental insurance, sometimes they call that Medigap insurance. It's the same thing. People ask me all the time, what's Medigap? It's the exact same coverage. Supplemental insurance, that combines. It's like the perfect little marriage because you have Part A and Part B of Medicare, and then you have your supplemental insurance.
When you get that supplemental insurance, do you buy that from an insurance company?
You buy that from an independent because it's a Highmark, a Capital, an Aetna, all the companies. We have about 35 right here in Berks County that
and
sell.
So if I wasn't using the county, because I can stay on as a pensioner, I can stay on the county thing. If I wasn't using the county, I would have Part A, Part B with Medicare, and that amount of money would be subtracted monthly from my Social Security check. Okay, how
correct.
Am I doing?
Correct.
And then to have a supplemental, I would have one of the local insurance companies be the supplier of whatever the 80% is, well, the 20% that Medicare didn't cover.
Correct.
How
correct.
Am I doing?
Correct. Now, remember, there's going to be a premium with your supplemental insurance. That doesn't come along as a freebie. Mm-hmm. So you are going to, and that's why you shop. You literally shop because, believe it or not, by federal law, they are allowed to charge whatever they darn well please. So you can shop, and there's lots of different plans to be able to pick. Right now in 2024, Sandy, you can pick a plan G, you can pick a plan N, which are the two most popular ones right now. There's a lot of other
now,
ones.
These are from insurance
these
companies.
These are insurance companies.
And where do you find out where the insurance companies are that offer this, besides being bombarded with mail?
Well, that's the easiest thing that you do. The other ones, basically, call Berks Encore, call the area agency on aging, or if you have a relationship with your own insurance man, somebody does your auto insurance, call them and ask them if they do it. They should be able to tell you that, okay, yes, we sell supplemental insurance. The interesting part, Sandy, that really just people, they go crazy with, is how do you pay for this supplemental insurance? Well, it's based on one simple fact, age at the time of enrollment. So the younger you are, 65, you buy a plan G, or if you wait to age 70, it just because it's both the start point is not going to be the same price.
When if you buy it at 65, does your premium stay the same no matter what?
No, it goes up. They
it's
going to go
oranges.
Up. It's going to go up. The other part of Medicare, which really happened back in 2007, was the Medicare prescription plan. And they call that Part D. Again, on your Medicare card, there's no indication of a D plan, a prescription plan, or supplemental insurance. Those are separate cards that you will carry. So you're really carrying three cards with you all the time. A Medicare card, a supplemental card, in your case, the county, or a prescription plan. So your prescription plan, the Part D, here we go again. That's not free, Sandy. That means you're going to go out and you're going to buy.
I should have run for controller again. And just kept running until I croaked. And then I wouldn't have had to go through any of this.
Yeah, because Part D, there is a prescription plan in 2024 that cost 50 cents a month. $6 for the whole year. I probably signed up during the open enrollment period, which I'll share with you in a couple of minutes. I probably signed up 250 people into that plan alone. And it's an excellent plan.
Does that really pay for everything?
Absolutely. Absolutely. In fact, I signed up my own honey, so unless I want to live in your shed, it better be a pretty good plan. But there are really good, there are very, very good Part D prescription plans out there that don't cost an arm and a leg. But if you're going to do your mathematics, and that's what this is all about, mathematics, Part B has a premium, $174.
Right.
Your supplemental insurance has a premium, age 65, somewhere between $146 and about $165. Here's your math. Then you can buy this really nice 50 cents a month prescription plan, and now you know how much your health insurance cost you.
Where are you going to get this 50 cents a month insurance plan? Is that part of Medicare?
Medicare offers Part D, but it's sold by individual insurance companies. Individual. So yes, now you have to go back and do your research again. So you call me, or you call Berks Encore, or you call the Area Agency on Aging.
Don't call me.
No, call me. Call me.
Because I don't have the foggiest idea how this is all working out.
And that's, you know, when people say Medicare is really confusing, it isn't. See, for me, it's not confusing anymore because it's all in there.
Yeah.
But guess what? From somebody just coming into this, coming off an employer plan, we have a lot that we need to make sure you're doing in the right steps. I just want to take a minute and cover Medicare Advantage plans, a whole different ball game that is offered by Medicare. Sometimes they call it Medicare C, but technically speaking, it is Medicare Advantage plans. Once again, Sandy, sold by individual insurance companies.
Huh.
So you can take a look at them. They work. There's not really a serious problem with them whatsoever, but Medicare Advantage plans is another option that people can have. I will tell you this much. Medicare itself and Social Security will tell you, you have 3 months prior to your birthday, the month of your birthday, and 3 months after your birthday to sign up for Medicare. So you do have a time frame to sign up for it. There used to be a penalty if you signed up late after that time, but that's gone. So now if you are turning 65 in February, you would have 3 months prior, 3 months after, and the month of February. But you should do that and get it. If you're going to continue to work, make sure you sign up for your Part A. Lastly, I just want to share, in the state of Pennsylvania, we have a program called the PACE and PACENET program. That is the pharmaceutical assistance program in the state of Pennsylvania. It is the number one assistance prescription plan in the country. $41,500 is the annual income, and you would qualify for it. So it is a decent amount of income. I certainly would highly recommend anyone that is on brand name drugs. If you qualify for the PACENET side, Sandy, you will never, ever, ever at any pharmacy pay more than $15 for a brand name drug.
But the revenue is $41,000 a year.
$41,500,
yep. If you have more than $41,500 a year coming in,
you do not qualify.
You have to be under that.
You have to be there or under, yes. Yes.
Okay, let's recap because we have about 5 minutes left. I can't believe it. Okay, this is the deal. Call Social Security, the 800 number, make an appointment, go on in, take in identification. When I went, I took my passport and I took my driver's license. And I did that because you have to prove who you are.
Who you are. Yep.
Okay. At 65 or whatever age, you can now sign up for Social Security. Is that when you hit that Part A Medicare?
Well, if you're going to sign up for your Social Security benefits, right now it's 66 years and 6 months.
Okay.
But your Medicare starts at 65.
So you're saying no matter when you can pick out Social Security at 65, you have to call Social Security and go in and sign up for Medicare Part A.
Part A, at least.
So 65... magic time for Medicare.
Yep.
Now then, if you're on Social Security, they will subtract your Medicare, if there's a fee, from your Social Security check. There is no fee for Part A.
Correct.
Part A is for the hospital.
Correct.
Part B is for, because I just had a blood test the other day. Blood tests, it's for x-rays, it's for...
your doctor, doctors, your specialists, all those.
And yep. I will tell you that some doctors do not participate in Medicare.
Mm-hmm.
When they don't, then you have to pay the full fee if you want to go to that doctor. So there are participating doctors for Medicare. So know before you make your appointment, if you want to choose your own doctor and they don't participate in Medicare, it's going to be up to you to pay the fee for that doctor's visit. You need to know that.
Yes.
I ran into that.
Yes.
Oh, this is like a whole new learning experience, I'm telling you. Anyway, make an appointment, go in at 65, sign up for Medicare Part A. When you're finished working and you're no longer covered by your company, then you can sign up for Medicare Part B.
Correct.
And that's for everything other than hospitals. You can sign up for D, which is a prescription program, and you can also sign up for an Advantage plan. If you want 800 numbers, call the Office of Aging to make your appointment, Social Security, or call Berks Encore. Both
Correct.
Of them do it.
Yep.
And if you want John,
I'll actually give you my number. How's that?
I'll go for it.
All right. You can actually call me. It's 610-779-6287.
Go get a pencil and paper. We'll say it one more time because we only have 2 minutes left over in the show.
Okay. 610-779-6287. That will get directly to me.
And he, honest to goodness, he knows all this stuff, which cracks me up because I'm like on the fast track to learn what the heck I'm doing. Okay, Strictly for Seniors is going to be on Sunday nights at 7 o'clock. We're going to have a YouTube thing that you can go back and look at the shows from the other days. And it's going to be as informative as it can be so that I can get seniors off their butts and out of the house. That is my new career. I'm telling everybody that I'm the BCTV Oprah.
There we go.
I don't expect to ever own this station, though. I'll tell you that right now. Thank you so much for tuning in. It's been a real pleasure. We're going to be having programs on financial planning, on wills, on funeral planning. We're going to have programs on the Berks Encore Centers. We're going to have programs on the different groups that meet at the churches, on trips. Thank you very much. It's been wonderful just being with you folks tonight. I just love this. It's so fun. It gives me a chance to continue to wear my Chico clothing. Thank you, everybody,
thank you.
And have a good day.
Thank you, Sandy.